Please stand. Jesus Christ is risen today. Alleluia. Our triumphant holy day. Alleluia. Who did once upon the cross, alleluia, suffer to redeem our loss. Hymns of praise, then let us sing, alleluia, unto Christ our heavenly King, alleluia, who endured the cross and grave, alleluia, sinners who redeem and save, the pains which he endured, alleluia, our salvation have procured, alleluia. Now he reigns above as King, alleluia, where the angels ever sing, alleluia. Sing we to our God above, alleluia. Praise eternal as his love, alleluia. Praise him, all ye heavenly hosts, alleluia. Father, Son, and Holy Ghost, alleluia. Jesus Christ is risen today, alleluia. Our triumphant holy day, alleluia. Who did once upon the cross, alleluia, suffer to redeem our loss, alleluia. Hymns of praise, then let us sing, alleluia, to Christ our heavenly King, alleluia, who endured the cross and grave, alleluia, sinners to redeem and save, alleluia. But the pains which he endured, alleluia, our salvation have procured, alleluia. Now he reigns above as King, alleluia, where the angels ever sing, alleluia. Sing we to our God above, alleluia. Praise eternal as his love, alleluia. Praise him, all ye heavenly hosts, alleluia. Father, Son, and Holy Ghost, alleluia.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My brethren, let us acknowledge our sin, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries.
I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault, therefore I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Christe eleison, Christe eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ. With the Holy Spirit in the glory,
Son, have conquered death and unlocked for us the path to eternity. Grant, we pray, that we who keep the solemnity of the Lord's resurrection may, through the renewal brought by your Spirit, rise up in the light of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter proceeded to speak and said, "You know what has happened all over Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John preached, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power. He went about doing good and healing all those oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses of all that he did, both in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. This man God raised on the third day and granted that he be visible, not to all the people, but to us, the witnesses chosen by God in advance, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commissioned us to preach to the people and testify that he is the one appointed by God as judge of the living and the dead. To him, all the prophets bear witness that everyone who believes in him will receive forgiveness of sins through his name." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. For his mercy endures forever. Let the house of Israel say, his mercy endures forever. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. The right hand of the Lord has struck with power. The right hand of the Lord is exalted. I shall not die but live and declare the works of the Lord. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. The stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done. It is wonderful in our eyes. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, if then you were raised with Christ, seek what is above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Think of what is above, not of what is on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ your life appears, then you too will appear with him in glory. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Christ the Lord is risen today. Christians, haste your vows to pay. Make your joy and praises known at the Paschal victim's throne. For the sheep the Lamb has bled, sinless in the sinner's stead. Christ the Lord is risen on high, now he lives no more to die. Christ the victim undefiled, God and sinners reconciled. When in strange and awesome strife met together death and life, Christians on this happy day haste with joy your vows to pay. Christ the Lord is risen on high, now he lives no more to die. Say, all wandering Mary, say, what you saw along the way. I beheld two angels bright, empty tomb and wrappings white. I beheld the glory bright of the risen Lord of light. Christ, my hope, is risen again. Now he lives and lives to reign. Christ, who once for sinners bled, now the firstborn from the dead, throned in endless might and power, lives and reigns forevermore. Hail, eternal hope on high, hail, our King of victory, hail, our Prince of life adored, help and save us, gracious Lord. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Our Paschal Lamb has been sacrificed. Let us then feast with joy in the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
From the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory to you, Lord. On the first day of the week, Mary of Magdala came to the tomb early in the morning, while it was still dark, and saw the stone removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and to the other disciple whom Jesus loved and told them, "They have taken the Lord from the tomb, and we don't know where they put him." So Peter and the other disciple went out and came to the tomb. They both ran, but the other disciple ran faster than Peter and arrived at the tomb first. He bent down and saw the burial cloth there, but did not go in. When Simon Peter arrived after him, he went into the tomb and saw the burial cloth there, and the cloth that had covered his head was not the burial cloth, but rolled up in a separate place. Then the other disciple also went in, the one who had arrived at the tomb first, and he saw and believed. For they did not yet understand the scripture that he had to rise from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Happy Easter. Our Lord has come back from the dead. Isn't that good? Today, we celebrate the resurrection of the Lord. And we have what feels like the conclusion of something, but is really the beginning of something else. The last 40 days, we did Lent, did we not? And for each one of us, we all have our own unique Lenten journey. How many of us were faithful to our Lenten promises for the whole 40 days? Exactly. Exactly. Lent is part of the struggle. The struggle is the whole point of Lent. If you do something for Lent that you do perfectly well, you've kind of missed the point. Because Lent is to show us the struggle. It's to show us humility to the point that we humble ourselves enough to repent. And hence, the sacrament of reconciliation has such a vital part of the Lenten journey. And so we have come to the end of Lent. And for those who have been through the process over the last 3 days, for those of you who've made it to Holy Thursday, to Good Friday, and even those who attended both the Easter Vigil and today, you see a transformation. Easter's not simply the end of Lent, where we celebrate Jesus coming back. It's not a once-and-done affair. If it was, it'd be in vain. No, we're beginning something new. And in fact, what we are about to embark on is actually harder than Lent. Because you see, the whole point of Lent is to recognize our humanity. It's to recognize our sins. And so if we fail during our Lenten penance, although that's not, quote, okay, it's kind of part of the deal. Because no one here is perfect. And our faults are part of the game. And when we fail, it teaches us a sense of humility. Because although none of us are perfect, and we all know this, how many of us here are pretty prideful? Nah. A lot of us struggle with the sin of pride. And it rears its head in the most sometimes blatant and otherwise subtle ways. And so, yes, Lent is to knock us off our high horse, if you will. And now we find ourselves in Easter. And it may sound like, oh, this is great. Jesus back. Jesus Christ is back from the dead. It is a time to be festive and joyous, is it not? Absolutely. And that is our duty. It is not simply something that we should do. It's something that we must do to the point that it should override everything else that you have in your life. And this here is what makes Easter a challenge. Because Easter is not simply one day. It is 50 days. And the church is asking you to be happy for 50 days. It's hard to be happy. So many of you have struggles in your day-to-day life. There's people at work you can't stand. You struggle with your family. You get on the road and somebody cuts you off, and what happens? You get mad. It is hard to be joyful. It shouldn't be this hard to do something that is good for us. But it is. And when we come into church on Easter Sunday and we hear the bells and we see the smoke, it should be an experience that pulls us out of ourselves. And it should give us a taste of what this joy will look like for all eternity. And yet, this joy that we experience, that should give us goosebumps and make us tremble? Well, we will auction it off to the first person that makes us mad. And we'll lose it. And so our duty during Easter is to be happy. Each and every single one of you is at a different place in your life. And to be frank, it may be really difficult for you at this point in your life to be happy. For those of you who have experienced recent tragedy, for those of you who have a broken heart, and for those of you who struggle with depression, today is the day we come to you and we pray with you and for you to set aside all of that
and to rejoice in the fact that Jesus Christ has come back from the dead. The tomb is empty, and yet it's hard to embrace. And we see that in the gospel today. It's beautiful. We see two disciples get to the tomb. Mind you, this is coming from John's gospel. He's writing it. And John writes that Simon Peter and him ran to the tomb, for John is the beloved disciple. And John, after all of these years, has to make us all know that when they ran to the tomb, he ran faster than Peter. And when they get to the tomb, though, because Peter's the one in charge, isn't he not? He was given the keys. John yields to him. And Peter goes in. And Peter sees the burial cloth there. But if you notice, the gospel says that he does not believe. It doesn't say that he believed. And yet, when John goes in, the gospel says that the disciple, other disciple also went in. And he saw and believed. John believed because he had that intimacy with the Lord. He was the beloved disciple. On the night of that Last Supper, what did John do? He rested his head on our Lord's chest, on his breastplate. The breastplate is a sign of protection. It's a sign of dignity. And so John, through that intimacy, gets it. Although he still does not quite understand. But he believes. And the joy of this Easter Sunday starts to radiate from him. To the point that he's able to make haste and to arrive at the tomb faster than Peter. It is our duty to be happy, and not just for today. Honestly, for the whole rest of our lives. And this is something that we're not good at. We get mad so easily. We walk around with so much stress and tension. Some people just don't like each other. And at the end of the day, that's not healthy. Is it hard to like people? Absolutely. Absolutely. Are we going to fail? Yeah. Yeah. But you cannot hate people. You can struggle in liking people. That's part of the journey. But we're not allowed to hate people. And we're not allowed to let ourselves auction off the joy of this Easter Sunday to the first person who makes us mad. That's not what we're here for. We have a duty to be happy. And particularly for the next 8 days, and in a special way, for the next 50 days. This is your task and this is your job. And so I'm going to give you what I tell every Easter Sunday. I give this advice at every Sunday. You have to be happy. Go home and rejoice. I don't care if you're going to go see family members that you don't necessarily like today. You have a duty to be happy. Go home. Cut yourself a big piece of pie. Eat, drink, and be merry. Pour yourself a nice stiff drink and rejoice in the fact that Jesus Christ has come back from the dead. This is your duty and it is your privilege. And we rejoice in the fact that Jesus Christ is risen from the dead. For we were the ones on Good Friday that yelled, "Crucify him." We have blood in our hands. And it is that blood that redeems us. And on Easter Sunday, all is at last made manifest. And we have the potential to experience an everlasting joy that can only be given by believing that Jesus Christ is back from the dead. Please remain seated. Remain seated.
My dear brethren, through this Paschal mystery, we have been buried with Christ in baptism, and so that we may walk with him in the newness of life. And so now that our Lenten observance is concluded, let us renew the promises of holy baptism, by which we once renounced Satan and all his works, and promise to serve you, to serve God in his holy Catholic Church. Please stand. And so I ask of you, do you renounce Satan?
I do.
And all his works?
I do.
And all his empty show?
I do.
Do you renounce sin so as to live in the freedom of the children of God?
I do.
Do you renounce the lure of evil so that sin may have no mastery over you?
I do.
Do you renounce Satan, the author and the prince of sin?
I do.
Do you believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
And may Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed on us forgiveness of our sins, keep us by his grace in Christ Jesus our Lord for eternal life.
Amen.
Amen.
All who are thirsty, all who are weak, come to the fountain, dip your heart in the stream of life, let the pain and the sorrow be washed away. In the waves of his mercy, his deep cries out to deep, we sing, come Lord Jesus, come. Come Lord Jesus, come. All who are thirsty, all who are weak, come to the fountain, dip your heart in the stream of life, let the pain and the sorrow be washed away in the waves of his mercy. Deep cries out to deep, we sing, come Lord Jesus, come. Come Lord Jesus, come. Come Lord Jesus, come. Come Lord Jesus, come. His deep cries out to deep, his deep cries out to deep, his deep cries out to deep, we sing, come Lord Jesus, come. Come Lord Jesus, come. All who are thirsty, all who are weak, come to the fountain, dip your heart in the stream of life, let the pain and the sorrow be washed away. In the waves of his mercy, his deep cries out to deep, his deep cries out to deep, as he cries out to deep, we sing, come, Lord Jesus, come. 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 Come, Lord Jesus, come.
With confidence in God, we come to thee with our prayers and supplications, and we ask that thou hearest our petitions.
O gracious Father, we humbly beseech thee for thy holy Catholic Church, that thou wouldst be pleased to fill it with all truth in all peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Give grace, O holy Father, to Francis our Pope and to Brendan our Bishop, and to all bishops and other sacred ministries, that both by their life and doctrine set forth thy true and lively word. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We beseech thee also, so to rule the hearts of those who bear the authority of government in this and every land, that they may be led to wise decisions and right actions for the welfare and peace of the world, especially in Russia and Ukraine. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
O Lord Jesus, who art the good shepherd that careth for thy flock, we beseech thee to bestow upon thy church the gifts of the Holy Spirit in abundance, and to raise up from amongst thy people vocations of deacon, religious, or priest. Inspire them to hear thy call and be spent for the sake of the gospel, and make them holy and loving servants and shepherds of the flock. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
O gracious Father, we ask that thou send forth thy blessing of rain on our parched lands. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We thank thee, O heavenly Father, for the years of blessings thou hast bestowed on Pope Benedict Emeritus on his 95th birthday. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
O God, who hast so consecrated the covenant of marriage that in it is represented the spiritual unity between Christ and his church, send thy blessing upon thy servants, William and Catherine Morrow, that they may so love, honor, and cherish each other in faithfulness and patience, in wisdom and true godliness. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. O good and gracious God, we cometh before thee on the day of thy Son's glorious resurrection. We ask that we may obtain with gladness his reward of everlasting life, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Jesus is risen, let us sing praise to the ever-living King. Alleluia, alleluia. Praise him in song, ye seraphim. Praise him with joy, ye cherubim. Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. On this this most holy day of days, let us together sing his praise. Alleluia, alleluia. Raise joyful voices to the sky. Sing out, ye heavens, in reply. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. To God the Father let us sing, to God the Son our risen King. Alleluia, alleluia. And equally let us adore the Holy Spirit evermore. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Is risen, let us sing praise to the ever-living King. Alleluia, alleluia. Praise him in song, ye seraphim. Praise him with joy, ye cherubim. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. On this most holy day of days, let us together sing his praise. Alleluia, alleluia. Raise joyful voices to the sky. Sing out, ye heavens, in reply. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. To God the Father let us sing, to God the Son our risen King. Alleluia, alleluia. And equally let us adore the Holy Spirit evermore. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Jesus is risen, let us sing praise to the ever-living King. Alleluia, alleluia. Praise him in song, ye seraphim. praise him with joy, ye cherubim. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Get ready. After the glory, after the prayers.
Great brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands
for the praise and glory of his name,
for our good and the cause of his glory.
Exalted with paschal gladness, O Lord, we offer the sacrifice by which your church is wondrously reborn and nourished through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Dominus vobiscum, et cum spiritu tuo, so sum corda abemos ad Dominum. Gratias agamus Dominum Deo nostro, dignum et justum est. Vere dignum et justum est, et quam et salutare. Te quidam Domine omni tempore confiteri, sed in ac portissimum die gloriosis predicare, cum pascha nostrum immolatus est Christus, ipse enim verus est agnus, quae absolit peccata mundi. Qui mortem nostrum moriendo destruxit, et vitam resurgendo reparavit. Qua propte profusis pascalibus gaudiis, tortus orbiterarum mundus exulta, sed et superne vertus anque angelice potestates, hymnum gloriae tuae commiunt sine fine dicentes.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest, hosanna in the highest.
Te igita clentesime pate, per ipsum Christum filium tuum, Dominum nostrum, supplices rogamus ac pedimus, uti acceptas abies, et benedicas, ac dona, ec munera, et sancta sacrificia iberate, in primis quae tibi offerimus, pro ecclesia tua santa catholica, quam pacificare, custodire, adunare, ed regite dignitatur obre terrarum, una cum famulor tuo papa nostro Francesco, et antister nostro Brendan, et omnibus orthodoxes anque catholice et apostolice fide cortolibus. Memento item Domine, famulorum famuloque tuarum. Et omnium circumstantium quorum tibis fides cognatia est et nota devotio, pro quibis tibi offerimus, velque tibi offerunt ac sacrificium laudis, pro sessusque omnibus, pro redemptione animarum suarum, pro spe salutis in comitate sue, tibi que verunt vota sua eterno Deo vivo et vero. Communicantes in diem sanctissime, celebrantes resurrectiones Domine nostre Jesu Christi, segun carnem sed et memoriam venerates,
In primis gloriosae semper Virginis Maria, genitis Iesum Dei et Domini Nostre Iesu Christi, sede beate Joseph, Iesum Virgi Sponsi, et beatorum apostolorum, ac materem tuorum, Petri et Pauli, Andre, Jacobi, Ioannis, Tomei, Jacobi, Felipe, Bartolomei, Matthei, Simonse et Tredei, Leni, Cleni, Clemente, Sixti, Corneli, Cipriani, Lorente, Crossogoni, Ioannis et Pauli, Casmi et Damiani, et omnium sanctuorum tuorum, quorum meritis perusque concedes et omnibus productiones tue manuarum auxilio. Hunc igitur, oblationem servitus nostre, sed et cutque familiae tue, quam tibi offerimus, pro is quodquo cos reginare dignatus es ex ac agua et sanctus spiritus sanctu, tribunus es remissionem omnium peccatuorum, quasimus domine ut plactus accipies, disque, nostros in tua pace disponas, anque ab aeterna damnatione nos eripe et in electuorum tuorum ubius grege numerare. Quam oblationem tu Deus in omnibus quasimus benedictum et scriptum ratum rationablum acceptablumque facidi dignitis et nobis corpus et sanguinis fiat delectissime filii Domini nostre Iesu Christi, qui pri quam patetur acceptum panem in sanctis ac venerables manus suas et elevitis oculis in cielo ad te Deum patem suum omnipotem tibi gratias agenes, benedixit, fregit, didique, discipulis suis digenes. Accipite et manducate, ex hoc omnis, hoc es erem corpus meum, quod pro vobis traditor. Simulum modo, postquam cenatum est, accipies in palicarum calicem, in sanctus ac venerables manus suas, item tibi gratias agenes, benedixit, dedique, discipulis suis digenes, accipite et bebite, ex eo omnis, ic es enim calic sanguinis mei, novi et eterni testamente, qui pro vobis et pro multis effeditur, in remuneration peccatuorum, hoc facite in meum commemorationem.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Udi et memoris Domini, nos servi tua, sed et plebs tua sancta, Iesum Christi filii Domini nostri, tam beate passionis, nec nom et ab infidis resurrectionis, sed et in celos gloriosi ascensionis, offerimus predicare maestate tua, de tuis donis ac datis, ostium purum, ostium sanctum, ostium immaculatum, panem sanctum viate eterne et calecem salutis perpetuae, supra quae proprio ac serino vultu, respicire dignitis et accepta abire, secuti accepta abire dignatus es, murere puri tui usti abil, et sacrificium patriarchi nostri Abrahani, et cortibi oblitud sumus sacerdos tuis Melchizedek sanctum sacrificium immaculatum ostium. Supplicis te rogamus omnipotens Deus, ubi ac preferi per manus sancti angeli tue, in sublime altare tuum, in conspectum divinia manistates tue, et quodco ex hoc altaris participatione sanctosanctum filii tue corpus et sanguinium supersedimus, omni benedictiones celestis et gratia replevamor. Memento item Domine famulorum famuloque tuorum, qui nos paresunt cum signo fidei, et dormunt in somo paces. Ipse Domine et omnibus in Christo crescentibus, locum refugi, refiri lucis et pacis, ut endugas de precamor, nobis proque peccatuoribus familias tues, de multitine remunerationem tuarum sebrantibus partem aliquam et sociatem donare dignitis, cum tuis sanctis apostolis et martibus, cum Ioanni Stefano, Matei Barnaba, Ignazio Alexandro, Marcellino Petro, Felicitate Perpetua, Agudad Lucia, Agnete Cecilia Anastasia, et omnibus sanctis tuis, entre quorum nos consortium non assumetor merite, sed viane quasimus legator admite, per Christum Dominum nostrum, per quam ac omnium, Domine, sempre bona cries, sanctificas, vivicas, bendices, et praestate nobis.
Per ipsum et cum ipso et in ipso, est tibi Deo Patri potente, in unitate Spiritus Sancti, omnis honor et gloria, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen, amen, amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in
Lord, we pray from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory,
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Pace Christi. No.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, who by the will of the Father and the work of the Holy Spirit, the year of death gave life to the world, free me by this your most holy body and blood from all of my sins and from every evil. Keep me always faithful to your commandments and never let me be parted from you. May the receiving of this body and blood, Lord Jesus Christ, not be for my judgment nor for my own condemnation, but through thy loving mercy, be for me protection of mind and body.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body of Christ keep me safe for eternal life.
Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. Therefore, let us keep the feast with the unleavened bread of purity and truth. Alleluia. Sacrifice. Therefore, let us keep the feast with the unleavened bread of purity and truth. Alleluia. Give praise to the Lord, for he is good. His mercy endures forever. Let the house of Israel say, his mercy endures forever. I called to the Lord in my distress. He has answered and freed me. It is better to take refuge in the Lord than to trust in man. The nations all encircled me. In the name of the Lord I cut them off. They encircled me all around. In the name of the Lord I cut them off. I was thrust down and falling, but the Lord was my helper. The Lord is my strength and my song. He was my Savior. There are shouts of joy and salvation in the tents of the just. The Lord's right hand has done mighty deeds. The Lord's right hand is exalted. The Lord's right hand has done mighty deeds. I shall not die, I shall live and recount the deeds of the Lord. I will thank you, for you have answered, and you are my Savior. The stone that the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done, a marvel in our eyes. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice in it and be glad. Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. Therefore, let us keep the feast with the unleavened bread of purity and truth. Alleluia. Christmas high feast we sing, praise to our victorious King. He has washed us in the tide, flowing from his open side. Praise we him whose love divine, gives his sacred blood for wine, gives his body for the feast. Christ the victim, Christ the priest. Where the paschal blood is poured, death's archangel sheaths his sword. Israel's horse triumphant go through the wave that drowns the foe. Praise we Christ whose blood was shed, paschal victim, paschal bread. With sincerity and love, heed we manna from above. Easter triumph, Easter joy, sin alone can this destroy. From sin's power to thou set free, souls newborn, O Lord, in thee. Hymns of glory, songs of praise, Father, unto thee we raise. Risen Lord, all praise to thee, with the Spirit ever be. At the Lamb's high feast we sing, praise to our victorious King. He has washed us in the tide, flowing from his open side. Praise we him whose love divine, gives his sacred blood for wine, gives his body for the feast. Christ the victim, Christ the priest. Where the paschal blood is poured, death's archangel sheaths his sword. Israel's horse triumphant go through the wave that drowns the foe. Praise we Christ whose blood was shed, paschal victim, paschal bread. With sincerity and love, heed we manna from above. Easter triumph, Easter joy, sin alone can this destroy. From sin's power to thou set free, souls newborn, O Lord, in thee. Hymns of glory, songs of praise, Father, unto thee we raise. Risen Lord, all praise to thee, with the Spirit ever be. Alleluia. Alleluia. For the Lord God Almighty reigns. Alleluia. Alleluia. For the Lord God Almighty reigns. Alleluia. Holy, holy are you, Lord God Almighty. Jesus, Allah, you are holy, holy. Are you Lord God Almighty? Worthy is the Lamb, worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb, worthy is the Lamb, worthy is the Lamb, worthy is the Lamb. Regina Celi, Laetare, Alleluia, qui aquae meruit si portare, Alleluia, resurrexit, sicut dixit, Alleluia, ora pro nobis Deum, Alleluia. Regina Celi, Laetare, Alleluia, qui aquae meruit si portare, Alleluia, resurrexit, sicut dixit, Alleluia, ora pro nobis Deum, Alleluia.
Let us pray. Look upon your church, O Lord our God, with unfailing love and favor, so that renewed by the paschal mysteries, she may come to the glory of the resurrection, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Happy Easter.
I just want to wish everyone a happy Easter. This was a beautiful Mass. I hope you all go forth and enjoy the glory of the resurrection.
I know we did things a little bit differently this Sunday, and my goal is to do this for Christmas and Easter and maybe for Pentecost as well. I know it's been a long time since some of y'all received communion at the commune rails, but I want to say, as a priest, being able to see your face receive communion is probably one of the most beautiful things. Y'all's facial expressions even change, and it's much more intimate, and it's beautiful. It's what I imagine Jesus saw when he saw John's face on the night of that Last Supper. So thank you for all of that. This was beautiful. Immediately following the final blessing, we're going to do another old tradition. There's going to be the recitation of the last gospel, which is the first chapter of John. So after the double Alleluia, please remain standing.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing.
Almighty God bless you. Through today's Easter solemnity and in his compassion, defend you from every assault of sin.
Amen.
And may he who restores you to eternal life in the resurrection of his only begotten Son endow you with the prize of immortality.
Amen.
Now that the days of the Lord's passion have drawn to a close, may you who celebrate the gladness of the Paschal feast come with Christ's help and exulting in spirit to those feasts that are celebrated in eternal joy.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Thanks be to God.
With you
and with your spirit.
The beginning of the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God, and all things were made by him, and without him was made nothing that was made. In him was life, and in the life was the light of all men. And the light shineth in the darkness, and the darkness did not comprehend it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. This man came for a witness to give testimony of the light, that all men might believe through him. He was not the light, but was to give testimony to the light, that was the true light, which enlightened every man that cometh into this world. He was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. He came unto his own, and his own received him not. But as many as received him, to them he gave power to become the sons of God, to them that believe in his name, who are born, not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but God. the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and we saw his glory and the glory of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth.
The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Alleluia, alleluia, hearts to heaven and voices raise. Sing to God a hymn of gladness, sing to God a hymn of praise. He who on the cross as Savior for the world's salvation bled. Jesus Christ, the King of glory, now is risen from the dead. Now the iron bars are broken, Christ from death to life is born. Glorious life and life immortal, on this resurrection morn. Christ has triumphed and we conquer, by his mighty enterprise. We with him to life eternal, by his resurrection rise. Alleluia, alleluia, glory be to God on high. Alleluia to the Savior who has won the victory. Alleluia to the Spirit, fount of love and sanctity. Alleluia, alleluia to the triune majesty.